God, I need you. Please rescue me. I know you said to trust you, and I know you told me to believe, but I find it hard to fight the voice inside of me that's saying there's no use in praying, 'cause things will never change.
Hello?
Hey, what's up?
Hi, this is my
Yeah, is she okay? Oh, okay.
Yeah. But
I just
learned. I was running from a brother. So you can work out as well. Yeah, she's been like sleeping and hurting.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, and they don't know. She was so crazy. They don't know where the bleeding is coming from. They can't figure out where the bleeding is coming from.
Yeah.
And I love God. I told her to.
We serve a mighty God. We serve a God mighty in battle, in control of everything. You take all the way doubts and fears, take it all away right now. And so now in Him, we can move and have our very being in the name of Jesus. So I speak healing right now on Sean's whole entire body in the name of Jesus. So that the report will come back that they don't know what happened. But her body is healed in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I thank you in advance. I thank you in advance, God. And I stand on it right now. I stand on your word, knowing that she will be healed. Thank you, Lord. Okay. All right, we good now. We good. We good. We don't have anything to worry about because guess what? It's in the hands of God. You know what I'm saying? So we'll have nothing to worry about. You know? So. Thank you. I'm doing a blog right now.
Huh?
I'm doing a blog right now on Facebook.
Are you really?
Yeah, like I'm actually recording right now. Like I recorded a whole conversation. I saw that you called, and so I just called you during it, so.
I was listening to Conqueror by Molly.
Oh, more than a conqueror. I love this song. I love that song. Actually, that song was my favorite song on the CD when I first got it. So all the other songs started growing me now, but.
The enemy comes only to
still. I love this whole album. I'm just kidding.
Mm-hmm.
I love every little song.
Go ahead. Hey, Destiny. Let me ask you a question. The blog question is what is the one of the most saddest moments in your life? And in contrast, what is the most happiest moment? So I want you to say that, okay? Go ahead.
Okay. The most saddest moment you said?
The most saddest moment in your life and the most happiest moment.
Um, I would have to say the most saddest moment in my life would have to be when my dad went through his death, spiritual death, or his physical death, should I say. That was probably the most saddest moment in my life. The chance for me to get to really, it came out in a positive perspective. And so I would say God really showed himself to be God, I am the Alpha and Omega. So that would probably be the most sad moment in my life, as far as physically. The most happiest moment in my life. Man, I have so many happy moments. I would say it was when we had my grandmother's 60th birthday. That's one of the happiest moments. It was good to get to embrace family, I think, at that point. And I love my family with all my heart. And so I would say that made me happy to get to embrace everybody and get to embrace the true perspective of what family is and their support. So I would say that's definitely one of the most happiest moments that's ever happened in my life.
Awesome. All right, well, you're going to be part of the blog, okay? So, I'm going to call you back. Let me finish it up.
Okay,
love you.
Love you.
Okay, bye-bye. One of the most saddest moments in my life is shared by two occasions. One was when I almost committed suicide when I was 16. I can't believe I felt so worthless as a human being. You know, I love my mother, and if anything happened to her, I would be devastated. But my grandmother, I mean, she practically, you know, took me, she raised me. So, on the contrast, was one of the most happiest moments of my life? Well, it's all, I think, one of the saddest, I think the saddest moment I had was when I almost committed suicide because I was just worthless. 16. 17 is one of the happiest. And that was when it was filled with the Holy Spirit for the first time in my entire life. I mean, it was so thick. You can cut the air with a knife. I know it's cliche, but it was like that. I mean, it was like I had to get some scissors and just, you know, cut a shape. It was, you either had to, while you're there, you either had to submit to the atmosphere or you had to get out because it was too heavy in there. You know, you couldn't breathe. I mean, I was filled with the Holy Spirit. The single-handedly, the best moment in my entire life. And I've been, you know, I'm close to 30. So that's the best moment so far that I've been living. And, wow. The Holy Spirit has been with me since then, since I was 17. Oh, man, it's just to think about that, it's just so awesome. I've had 11 years of experience with the Holy Spirit, and I've not always been obedient to it, but the times that I have saved my life, so that's Jim and Nip's real talk moment. Be bloggers. Didn't make a promise to you.